For those of you who don't know me, my name is Glenda. A number of months ago, we produced the first book in a series of books to help augment and supplement the use of your SureFit Designs kits, and that book was called Pants That Mix and Multiply. Well, the second book is now hot off the press, and it's called Bodices That Mix and Multiply Beyond Bodice Basics. And how did I get my content for this book? Well, I listened to your input. I sent out a survey and you told me what you wanted to see. And one of the dominant requests was how to do the empire line. So there is all the directions that you need for creating an empire line that fits your bust line properly. In addition to that, you wanted to know how to mix the empire line with the princess line. And so we do that. You know, that princess line is so flattering on so many different figure shapes. The second most dominant request was how to do a cowl neck blouse. So there are actually two different variations of the cowl neck. And one of the things that we're seeing in ready-to-wear right now is a cardigan with a diagonal hem, a pointed hem. And it's very, very easy to make off of your SureFit Designs kit, so you're going to get directions for that. And then we finish off with showing you a couple of jackets, the bolero jacket. It's great for covering up the sleeveless garments and protecting you from cool air conditioning. This book is actually 28 pages long, and it not only shows you how to work with your master patterns and your blueprint, body blueprint, but it also gives you general sewing directions. But to make this all really come into focus for you, each book is accompanied by a how-to DVD, and this focuses on the pattern work, so you can actually see me drawing off the patterns. You know, I know that you're really going to enjoy working with Beyond Bodice Basics, so now let's segue in and take a look at each of these different styles. Marlene is showing us our first empire line style. Notice the three distinctive portions: the upper bodice, the midriff, and the skirt. Here, the bodice has that surplice or crisscross. The bust fitting dart has gone down into the top of the midriff section, and soft gathers are created right here. The midriff is one that I've done out of a contrasting fabric, and I've put in some soft pleats there, but you could have sheared this or left it totally plain. The skirt is cut on the bias, and the dart space. See, the empire line is combined with the princess line. The side-fitting bust dart got transferred up into the shoulder line, but then we created a side front panel and a center front panel, and when sewn together, give that beautiful shaping over top of the apex. The remainder of that waist-fitting dart actually got combined with the top of the hip-fitting dart on the skirt, and then this entire section was created into the As we go beyond the empire design, the next style that we're going to take a look at is how to create a cowl neck. Now, the word cowl actually is derived from the monk's hood. In our situation, we have beautiful draping coming from the shoulder and creating this lovely, lovely fullness at center front. Additionally, the bust dart has been transferred into center front, which also adds more draping. And typically, a cowl neck bodice is cut on the bias. Again, more draping. Now, it can be stitched out of it. Variation number two of the cowl neck features a very, very pretty decorative shoulder piece that's been designed and cut away, and I've sewn it in a contrasting fabric. Of course, that choice is yours. And from that design line, the actual cowl neck draping begins at that spot, at that place. Then, the sleeve is 3/4 length. The next design featured in Beyond Bodice Basics is this really comfy cardigan. This cardigan features a really wide collar, and when that's turned inside and folded back and scrunched up around your neckline, it is just so comfortable and cozy to wear. The center front is one of those very, very long diagonal front designs that goes way, way down. And from center front, that hem point then comes up into the side seam, so you get this. Design number six is this very comfortable bolero jacket, which is perfect for over top of sleeveless garments. It can be sewn out of either a knit or a woven fabric, and whether you do it out of either knit or woven, this bust fitting dart should still stay in place. It's going to give you really excellent fit. Here I've transferred it up into the arm side. And the center front is just a very simple curvature that I've done with the designing style. And last but certainly not least is a variation of the bolero pattern. Here you're seeing a V-neck that comes into a button overlap and into a very gentle curve at the front. The waist is...